And weather creating problems as well down further south. A possible tornado to the east of Iowa City left one person injured, damaged buildings, and ripped up trees.
And this morning, we've got Josh Sheinblum live in Muscatine this morning to give us the scope of the cleanup that residents are now faced with today. Josh, good morning.
Join Jason. The people here of Muscatine say there was no warning when high winds ripped right down Highway 38, going right through the center of town. And while we do not have it confirmed yet that an official tornado went through here, when you look around, it looks like it has all the indications of one. There is insulation here that covers this entire area right off of the highway. You don't have to look far at the buildings to see just how much damage has already been done. We're here this morning right next to Chevrolet Buick GMC of Crager. There is a large pile of steel there, we're told by local residents, came from the roof of either that building or Muscatine Toyota right next to the street. It's crumpled up like a piece of paper, and that sort of destruction is what we're seeing even in terms of trees. There are limbs that scatter this entire area here. If you look over there, there are large branches that have fallen down. We're right across the street from the Kent Corporation. One of their main trees has also completely fallen over here, and it looks like this is just the kind of devastation that we've seen throughout the greater part of the morning through the center of town. And if you are planning on waking up doing any sort of traveling, the Muscatine Police Department does say that you should be advised. They are running a number of patrols here throughout the area to try to not only survey the damage, but make sure that people stay safe as well. In just a last few moments, I got off the phone with a couple members of the National Weather Service. They say they're going to be sending out a survey team in just a couple short hours away to not only survey the damage, but figure out if a tornado did in fact go through, and if it did, how large it was. We are covering Muscatine. Josh Sheinblum, CBS 2 News.
All right, thanks a lot, Josh. And
Jason and Joy, we're here this morning right off of Highway 38, one of the places where local authorities tell us a tornado ripped through much of the center of town, causing damage to a number of local businesses here. And while the tornado may have come through here a few hours ago, you don't have to look far to see that there is still a lot to clean up. There's lots of branches, lots of debris. This morning, we are in between two different car dealerships, Toyota of Muscatine, as well as Crager of Chevrolet Buick GMC. Right where I'm standing this morning, you can see that there is clearly damage to the buildings here in this area. I just picked up a piece of insulation, and insulation is scattered all over here, much like the cars they have in their parking lot. We take a walk around now to the back side of this dealership, and you can actually see parts of what I believe are their roof crumpled up, large, thick pieces of steel, much like a piece of paper. And it's not just limited to building infrastructure where we're seeing damage here this morning. This is just a few trees that we've seen. They are knocked over. They are bent. A lot of damage as far as trees are concerned here this morning. And it's not just off of Highway 38 where you're going to find some damage. We've been talking with local folks here this morning about the things that they've seen in the wake of these high winds. We have heard reports that there are still tractor trailers turned over at one local business, that a Menards here in town sustained some serious damage as well. Even the Kent Corporation right across the street. I'm not sure you can see it given just how dark it is this morning, but what was the one of their large trees in front of that building has also completely fallen over this morning. We arrived here on scene just a couple hours ago. We've had a lot of time to survey the damage, and it looks like the people here of Muscatine are going to have a lot of work to still do to clean everything up. The Muscatine Police Department says that today they're going to be patrolling to make sure that everyone still remains safe given all of the destruction that's around here in this community. For now, we are in Muscatine. Josh Sheinblum, CBS 2 News.
All right, thanks a lot, Josh.